good morning. We're going to try and do a painting this morning. First time having a go. We're going to get started and throw some paint up there. Cadmium yellow. I've already got a canvas here, already coated. It's had two coats of white gesso, and also we've had some magic white on it as well. Don't be shy with this, just throw it up there. There we go. Let's just have fun. We can have a bit of fun. Just makes the day go a bit better. See that? Just enough on the brush. There you go. Feel that beautiful. That's just nice. We go for the next colour now. I'll just take this off the plate. The next colour we're going to use is Indian yellow. Same again, just a splash. See that? Not even clean the brush. Just tips of the brush. There we go. Straight into the canvas. There's no playing around. All this is going to be blended. This stage of things, it doesn't matter what you get. Even them lines will disappear at the end of it. We've changed the paint over. And the next paint's yellow ochre. Same again, just a line of it on a plate. Yeah. Just get a mixing on the brush. Yeah, lovely. If only you can just do this. We'll also have a little bit in the water. Another bit of that in the water. That was a bit like that, wasn't it? Just a shimmer. Next. We need some of the light red. These are all Bob Ross colours, these. These are all Bob's paints. They have a nice strong pigment to them, so the colours really stand out. See that? Don't be shy with this. Just put it up there for all to see. Yeah. And once we start blending this, this'll all change. In the water as well here. There we are, we're starting to get something together. Looks a mess in a minute. We're going to alter that soon. We're going to make an addition here of blue and black. This is the Phthalo blue of Bob Ross's. Very strong. A very strong blue indeed. And again, we've not cleaned any brushes yet. Line of paint. We need a bit of black on there, don't we? Blue and black. A nice bit of blue. Go in there. Look at that, that's a nice bit of blue. And on with the black, just a touch in the black. There we go, straight to the top. Crisscrosses. That's all I'm doing, crisscrosses. Just crisscrosses, we get this on. And the sooner we get this done, the sooner we're on to some painting. And same again, here we go, bit of blue and black. This time we'll go right down here. Nice enough. Right, we get across to the water area now. It's the same again. On with a bit of blue. And on with a bit of black. I want my water line about there. So quite a long sweep with this one. All the way to the top. Yeah. jab again on the opposite side. Tricks I do with the water, if you look at my paintings, there's all different shades in the water. I do this by introducing a little bit more black. Same again on the brush, same brush. That nice dark colour there. The difference, okay. I'm going to do the same again the other side. It's only a short distance here we're going. Yeah, see the two layers. That will make a stronger one now. Just come from this side. This all qualifies as the painting progresses. Right, the next step is to blend all this in. Try and make some sense out of it. Now, it's a 3-inch brush. I'm going to go into this. With a steady pressure. See how that's all coming together? Get that wipe out. It's all coming together now. Oh, that's nice. That's nice. Yeah, that's coming. You just need a little bit more red in the sky. Get some more red. Just a bit more red. That's nice and warm now. Again, just nicely sweep that in. Lovely. This is like high speed painting, this. I've never done this before, so stay with me. Next stage. Blending the bottom of the water area. Same again. Look how nice that's coming. That's lovely. A little bit of ripple here, so we come into this bit of colouring.